Mishnah Kriyot Perek Vav Mishnah Dalet. 4th minute of the 6th and final chapter of Masechet Kriyot. Very interesting Mishnah. Chayavei Chataot Ve'ashamot Vada'im. If you're Chayav, a Korban Chatat Vada'i, or a Korban Asham Vada'i. For sin, you know you did. Sha'avar Le'am Yom Kippurim. And you pass through Yom Kippur. So we know Yom Kippur is Mechaper. The Torah says, the Mishnah says nonetheless, Chayavin lahavi la'achar Yom HaKippur. You still have to bring the Korban after Yom Kippur. Why? Because in the last mission we talked about Yom Kippur, about Baba Ben Buti, who they made him, they wouldn't let him bring a Korban after the day of Yom Kippur. So once we're talking about Yom Kippur, okay, then we're going to talk about Yom Kippur in terms of its atonement for a certain Korbanot. So if you already have a Chatat or a Hashem, Yom Kippur doesn't erase it. Why? The Amar Kra, the Torah says, Mikol chatotechem lifnei Hashem titaru. You shall be purified mikol chatotechem from all of your sins before God. Which ones? Chet she'en makir bo el hamakom. The sin that you no one knows about except hamakom, except God. Tehainu shelo noda lo shechata. Meaning he doesn't know that he sinned. Those sins Yom Kippur mechaper. Yom Kippur gives you an atonement for the sins you don't know about. Aval chet ika diyadavei. But if there are sins that someone knows about, meaning, even if I don't know about it, but somebody comes along after Yom Kippur and says, oh, you sinned before Yom Kippur, you can't say, I'm exempt, Yom Kippur is Mechaper. No, because somebody knew about it. Those sins, Yom Kippur is not Mechaper. Therefore, there's still Chayav after Yom Kippur to bring your Korban. But, Chayavei Ashamot Taluyim, remember we learned about Asham Talui. Asham Talui, you had two pieces of meat. One of them was straight, one of them was not. You ate one of them, you're not sure which one. So in that case, after Yom Kippur, Pturim, you're exempt. Why? Because the whole point of the Korban, Asham Talui, remember, is to push off the onesh, possibility of punishment. And it was for the unknown. We said Yom Kippur is Mechaper for the unknown. So therefore, you don't have to bring your Korban, Asham Talui, after Yom Kippur. So what happens if you have a Safek Avera? Maybe you ate it, maybe you didn't. Maybe Kazayit, you ate a thing and you know it with yes Kazayit, not Kazayit, or whatever. On Yom Kippur, afil im chashecha, even up to before dark, patur, you're exempt. Why? Shekol hayom mechaper, the entire day of Yom Kippur is mechaper, even until the very last moment, which makes sense to us intuitively because we know from the Ilah, you wait till the very last moment, and even that small amount can bring a kapara. We'll dedicate our learning to the memory of Tzipora Bat Shmuel Moshe Deborah Leah. Make it a great day.